Have you ever wanted to share a location in your apps only to find that you're dealing with mysterious numbers? Users think of their location based on the place they're at, not latitudes and longitudes. The Places API for Android solves this by enabling you to present locations as meaningful entities. Google's comprehensive and trusted Places database contains businesses, pet stores, shopping malls, embassies, and of course, my favorite, theme parks. Google has more than 100 million places from all over the world. It's the most comprehensive list of places you'll find. I'm Anchor Cotwell, and I'm going to show you how to make location in your app more personable. This can take the previous experience and make it into something like this. The Places API has been available as a Google web service for some time, but it is now available as a native Android API through Google Play Services 7, meaning you can use it in your Android apps right away, supporting users all the way back to Android 2.3 Gingerbread. Being a native Android API results in a more accurate list of returned places, since the user's current location can be more reliably determined. Now, perhaps the most common question users want to answer is, where am I? The Places API makes it easy for you to give them that answer through the Place Picker. This is a ready-to-use widget that displays a list of nearby places, and using it is as simple as calling the Place Picker to be displayed. The result is a place object, which comes with really useful details such as addresses, phone numbers, and URLs. Each place has a unique place ID, and you can cache this ID so that if you ever need to retrieve that same place again, you can do so easily using the getPlaceByID method. If you don't want to use the place picker, nearby places can be programmatically retrieved through the getCurrentPlace method. Now, this API returns a list of places so that you can present them in your own custom picker if you choose. If you're like me, you don't enjoy typing long place names on mobile keyboards. Chances are that your users feel the same way. The autocomplete API delivers suggested place names and addresses based on what's been typed so far. If, however, the user is not able to find their place in the list of results, you can ask your users to add new places and feed this data to Google through the addPlace method. Now, when adding a new place, you can then report that the user is at that place via a place report. And this captures signals to identify that place automatically in the future. Newly added places will be available to users in your app and could ultimately be added to Google's global places database. So when it comes to location, the Places API makes it really easy to free your users from a world of long, mysterious numbers by bringing real entities to your apps. The sample code at this link contains everything you need to get started in dramatically improving your users' location experiences. I look forward to seeing what you build using Places.